Shabbat Shalom.
Yahweh Yeshua jumping in the midst of Yahweh that maybe watching on Everton TV or Can TV or on the internet, YouTube. We thank you again. And as always, our prayer is to be a blessing to you and the word of Yahweh that you hear will comfort you and uplift you.
Yes, yes,
it will. We encourage you to keep on walking with Yahweh.
Yes.
Praise Yahweh.
The subject we're still in, the word Hazah.
Hazah.
We get strength.
Okay.
We get courage. That's the definition. We get strength. We get courage. We be strong. All those definitions come from that Hebrew word and more. Okay? So, we want to be encouraged. Because Yahweh told us to be encouraged.
Yes, he did.
Be of courage. Be
that's
of
right.
courage. And
that's
be
right.
Strong.
Tobin Kazak.
So he commissioned us to do that, so we're going to do that. So we left off on the last lesson at 2 Kings or 1 Kings, I should say. And 22, chapter 22 and verse 18, I believe we stopped that. So we'll pick it back up there. Again. Pray that our ears and eyes be open unto this word.
Yes.
And that we can receive it into our spirit. And we can do it. Because how he's given us the power.
Yes, he has. Yes, he has.
If you know that you have the power to do it, then you can act on it.
Yes,
you
can.
If you don't know that you got the power, then you can't act.
That's right. How can
you? I mean, the brother was on the phone before service. Hey, if you don't know you got something, you can't use it.
No, you cannot.
So the devil has the advantage of
it. Yes, he does. Teach it, tell it like it is, right. So hams can know.
Right. So this word, what? Hazah.
Hazah.
It's used 290 times in scripture, okay?
Okay.
But it's not used all the time as strength. It's not only. As
that's
strong.
Right.
It's
teach it, tell it like it is, so hams can know.
Encourage or courageous.
Okay.
So it's used in many better definitions
yep.
of the word that you can get from it.
Right.
To fail, to harden, to grow strong, to be strong, right?
Yeah.
But Yahweh has put it there for us to know that we have access to it.
Yes.
Praise Abba Yahweh.
Praise Abba Yahweh.
So, what did I say we left off at?
1 Kings 22:18.
Yes. All right, we'll pick it up right there. 22:18. And it reads,
and the high Malik of Israel, Amon, to Jehoshaphat, did I not tell thee that he would prophesy no toll concerning me but wrath?
So he's telling him, he wanted him to prophesy true, but then he was when the prophet said, okay, I'm going to tell you everything that you want to know, then he said, I told you, did I tell you to tell me the truth, not but the truth all the time?
Yeah.
Then the man tells him the truth. Now, did I tell you that he would not prophesied nothing good about me? So you really can't win when you're dealing with Satan and his
right.
okay
his adversaries, okay, no matter what you do.
That's right.
You can't believe it. So the best thing for you and I to do is to please Yahweh.
That's right.
Right.
Speak what thus says Yahweh.
So he said, and Amalek of Israel, Amad unto Jehoshaphat, did I not tell thee that he would prophesy no good thing or told thing, excuse me, concerning me, but evil, but rock, right?
Yeah, yeah.
And he Amad, verse 19.
And he Amad Shemay, thou for the Hadabab Yahweh. I saw Yahweh sitting on his throne, and all the sorrows of Shemayim standing by Yahweh on his Yahmain hand, on his Shemu.
So this is what he replied. He said he heard. So when you hear the word of Yahweh, then you are heed to the word of
that's
Yahweh.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's it. You should.
So, when the word of Yahweh is spoken to you, you may not like it, but
that's right.
It's for your good.
It is a fire told.
It's for your good.
Yes, it is.
Not for his. He already got everything.
That's right. That's
other
right.
Word, we talking about, he's telling them to be encouraged, but don't be encouraged doing something wrong.
If you
get,
so the other king
right.
that was with Ahab, he wanted the man of Yahweh to prophesy to him, let him know what was going on.
Mm-hmm.
But then he kind of got persuaded by the other king
okay.
who wanted to appease him and go fight with him because they were Israel. But we don't want to do that. We're not appeasing people.
No, we're not.
And if it displeases Abba Yahweh, then we're not
appeasing
them.
We're not going there.
He always want to do the things that please Yahweh.
That's it. All the time.
If it's pleasing man and not pleasing Yahweh, then guess what? It's no good.
Not for us.
Right.
No good for us, right?
Nope.
No. It's just giving, letting us know how people need to be encouraged or be strong in Yahweh.
That's right.
Praise
Abba
Yahweh. Okay, let's look at 2 Kings chapter 3. 2 Kings chapter 3. So, these are examples of people being strong or being encouraged to do things by the word of Yahweh.
The bars of Yahweh.
So we need to be encouraged by the Dabar of Yahweh.
That's
we should
right.
be comforted by the Dabar of Yahweh.
You should. Yes, you should.
Encouraged by the Dabar of Yahweh. It should always lift us up.
Yes, it should. Praise the mighty Yahweh.
Down, so we read the Dabar of Yahweh, that should encourage
us. Praise the mighty Yahweh. That's right. Praise him.
Don't let him, when the scripture says, don't let him steal your joy.
No.
Right.
Never again.
Your joy is your strength.
In the Dabar's of Yahweh.
And your strength is Yahweh.
That's right? Praise him.
So we have to know that.
Yes.
Well, if we don't know that, the enemy have advantage over
us. Yes,
him,
he will.
Chapter 3, let's start at verse 13. And read.
And Elisha among to the high mountain of Israel, what have I to do with thee? Get thee to the high Na'vi. Be of Diara and not into the Na'vi of Diam and the high Malach of Israel unto him. Nay, for Yahweh have corralled these three Malachs together to deliver them into the hand of Moab.
So be encouraged. You hear somebody prophesy, so verse 11, if you read it, then you'll see what he's talking about. But your Jehoshaphat, Ahmad, it and went on. So we don't, you want Ahmad, don't want to. Not listen to what Yahweh said,
right?
Elias said unto the Malik, or the king of Israel, what have I to do with thee? Get thee to the prophet of thy Abba, or of thy father, and to the prophet of thy Im.
Okay, right.
And the Malik of Israel amad unto him, nay, for Yahweh hath corralled me, or called thee three kings together to what?
Deliver them
unto thine hand, to the hand of Moab. So Yahweh is called, so he's instructed. So don't be afraid. They already been delivered.
That's
all
right.
You got to do is go and take possession.
That's right. Go stand for thus says Yahweh.
So why you be afraid? You're looking at circumstances.
Right.
How big they are, but Yahweh says, I have delivered them
to
your hand.
Yes, he has. Yeah. Yes, he will.
You know he delivered them to your hand, you got to go out there and take
that's
it out.
That's right. That's it.
Take it up, okay?
Yeah.
Right.
So this is what Yahweh, so these people were courageous and they went on and did what Yahweh said. Verse 14 says,
and Elijah, Amon, as Yahweh of Shalel's Kiah, before whom I stand, surely, were it not that I regard the presence of Jehoshaphat, the high Malach of Yehuda, I will not look toward thee nor see thee.
I will not look toward thee nor see thee, right? Because Yahweh already told you what happened. Don't be looking to nobody else but to the one that commanded you to do this, right?
Right.
Next verse says,
but now bring me a minstrel. And that it came to pass when the minstrel played that the hand of Yahweh came upon him.
And he played, the hand of Yahweh came up on it. So you just follow Yahweh's plan, and the thing going to work out.
That's right.
Stop looking at circumstances.
That's it. Teach it, tell it like it is.
Keep your eyes on him, on his word, on
that's
what
right.
he said, and see that he's going to perform.
Yes, exactly he will.
He said. He's able to perform everything that
he said. Yes, he is.
But when we take our eyes off of what he said,
right,
and start looking at the situation, looking at what somebody else said, hey, then we are missing the mark.
Yes,
right?
We will.
Yes.
Well, that will cause us to be fearful.
Yes, it will.
People look at the unknown beyond their five senses.
They can't see.
They can't see the power of Yahweh.
They cannot.
So you have to become a spiritual
person. That's it. Teach it. Tell it like it is. Praise the mighty Yah. Teach it.
See the word of Yahweh. Without the spirit of mind.
You must have it.
Then you can't be in tune
with Yahweh. No, you cannot.
Okay? You take the example when Shimiel, he had not been able yet to hear the voice of Yahweh.
Uh-huh.
So you have to come to a part where you'll be able to hear
that's
the voice
right.
of Yahweh.
We do.
You must humble yourself.
You got to be kind of know the voice of Yahweh
yes.
from the voice of Sartum.
Yes, teach it.
Distinguish Yahweh's voice from the voice of Sartum because he's going to sound good.
Yeah, Hasatan.
It's not going to be good.
No, it's not. Not in the end. Not
for
in
a moment,
end.
It might be good.
Yeah.
You know? Sin for a moment is good.
Yeah, it's pleasant for a moment.
You
have
to do that. It's good for a moment, but in the end, it's like gravel in your throat.
That's right. It's destruction.
So you don't want that. Because it look good, it feel good for a moment, but the end is not what you're looking for.
No,
the
it's
end
not.
Is not what you're
not
looking
the
for.
Very end.
Let's look at Nehemiah. Malachimiyah, chapter 6. So these are people that was encouraged. And they were strong to do exploits that Yahweh had called them to do.
Yes.
He calls us to do exploits beyond our human capacity.
Right, yeah. Right. Yes, he does. Yes, he will.
Because he's with us.
Yes, he is.
David said, though I walk through the valley of shadow of death, I will feel no evil.
That's right.
Because he knows who was with me. Who was with him?
Yahweh. Yeah, so.
You know he's with you, you don't have no fear.
That's it. Right. None.
Hallelujah.
But if you have doubt he's with you, then you're going to have fear.
Yes,
right?
You will.
Chapter 6 and verse 11 of Nehemiah. And it reads,
and I am such a yardner as I flee. And who is there that bring as I am would go into the temple to save his cat? I would not go in.
I would not what?
Go in.
He would not go in. So he gonna do what Yahweh said. We don't go beyond Yahweh. We don't get in front of
Yahweh. That's right. That's right.
We're gonna mess about it. We stop getting in the front
that's
of Yahweh.
That's right.
See what happens when we get ahead of Yahweh.
Huh.
Right.
Do not get ahead of Yahweh.
Okay. Yeah. Wait on Yahweh. That's right.
We are the tail. So, let's not get ahead of
that's
Yahweh.
Right.
Get in ahead of Yahweh. Bad things happen.
Yes, it does. Okay. Teach and tell like it is for the animals to know.
Okay, I'll go back and read it. I'll read it again. One more time.
And our minds should search a Adam as I flee. Who is there that being as I am would go into the temple to save his cat? I would not go.
I would not go. He said. And I said, should such a man as I flee? Well, he wasn't going to flee into the temple.
No.
And who is there that being as I am would go into the temple to save his cow? So you go in and save it, you may lose it.
Yeah, that's what Yah said.
From the enemy.
Right.
That's what Yah said.
Yahweh gives us armor.
Yes,
all
he does.
Armor we read about is what? In front of us.
Yes.
So if we flee, that means our back is turned to the enemy.
Uh-huh.
Right?
Amen.
So it's right. Vulnerable.
Yes, that's
right.
It.
So you don't want to have your vulnerable part to the enemy.
Nope.
Praise Abba Yahweh.
Praise Him.
Why would I go in there to flee?
Uh-huh.
To save my cow. I will not go in. Verse 12.
And lo, I perceive that Yahweh had not sent him, but that he pronounced this prophecy against me for Tobiah and Sanballat and had hired him.
So that's what you got to hear the word of Yahweh and then you can perceive.
Yes.
He perceived that the message that was brought to him it wasn't sent for
Yahweh. Okay.
So we have to perceive.
Yes.
When somebody brings us a message and says it's from Yahweh.
Yeah.
Because Yahweh's given us his Ruach HaKodesh.
Yes, he has.
So that means we have the capacity to receive
yes.
or precede something that's been told you.
That's right. That's rock of discernment.
Or some scripture going to come into mind.
Yes. That's
not lined up.
That's right.
With how
that's
Yahweh right. deal with people, okay?
That's right.
So now he perceived that this was not from him. This was his own precept. Or this is his own thing that come out of his mind.
Uh-huh.
So we have a lot of that going on today. Okay? So we have to be, so he pronounced this prophecy of his, against me because somebody has sent him to do that.
Okay.
Not Yahweh though.
That's right. Not Yahweh. Yahweh don't pay no one.
So since you believe in Yahweh, Satan will send somebody to prophesy something against you that's like Yahweh is doing this.
Uh-huh. Okay?
So now you have to still have to, you're vulnerable if you don't believe the word of Yahweh.
That's right. You don't
if
stand on the
able
word.
To perceive the word of Yahweh.
Right.
Then you're open to what he said. Okay, we see when Satan came to Yahshua, he's saying, hey, Yahshua wasn't vulnerable because he knew the word of Yahweh.
That's right.
Amen.
He said, get thee behind me.
Okay? Uh-huh.
The devil say, hey, you bow down to me, I give you all this. Why? You sure already know. This already mine.
That's right. Praise Yahweh. Praise him. That's right.
So you already know. You already got what you both have. When Adam and Hawa, when Satan come down, if they had realized or thought and perceived what Yahweh said, they already like Yahweh.
Right. That's it.
Right.
They were made in his image, in his likeness, so they was already like. They didn't have to try to be like. Right. They were already like.
That's right.
They know all they knew was good, so Yahweh is good, right?
Yes,
so that's all you need to know. Why you need to know about evil?
That's right.
You don't need to.
I mean, like you want to do some evil then, right? You want to know about evil, then you
right.
Right.
Kind of lean into that toward you want to do some evil, okay?
Uh-huh.
But the next verse says, or did we finish that one?
12,
right? That's what we read, right?
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Therefore was he hired that I should be afraid to do so, and that they might have matter for raw report, that they might reproach me.
So therefore I have to know. I have to
You have to know.
So Yahweh has encouraged me to do something. So here's somebody trying to discourage me from doing something.
Right, right.
And using probably using the word of Yahweh to do that. Okay?
Yeah.
So, but Yahweh said, be courageous.
Right. Uh-huh.
Be strong.
Yeah.
Be encouraged. Not discouraged. Be encouraged.
Yes.
To do what I said, right?
Right, right.
Read that again.
Therefore was he hired that I should be afraid and do so, and hata that they might have matter for a raw report, that they might reproach me.
So they was hired to do this to make him be afraid.
Yeah.
Yahweh told us not to be afraid.
That's right. Yes,
Yahweh told us not to fear. Don't be afraid. Because I'm with you.
Yes.
Always remember, when somebody trying to make you be afraid, remember, Yahweh say, I'm with you.
That's right.
You sure say, I'm with you to the what?
Yes.
So, remember these scriptures. These scriptures not there. He didn't put them there just to be putting them there.
No,
right?
He did not.
Put them there for they have meaning.
Yes.
And by reading them, you get the meaning. You get the strength. You get the courage.
Yes, you do.
The confidence you need.
Yes, you will.
To do what Yahweh is calling you to do, right?
Praise God. Praise the mighty Yah. Hallelujah.
They might reproach me. So if I be afraid, now they got an evil report.
That's right.
So he's afraid.
Uh-huh.
Yahweh told you not to be afraid, right?
Right. Right.
Now they can reproach you.
Uh-huh.
Because you got out. Verse 14 said,
my Elohim, think thou upon Tobiah and Sanballat according to these their deeds, and on their prophetess Noadiah, and on the rest of the high Navi that would have put me in fear.
So these are the things. So now he turned by and said, put these things up on him, right?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And would try to deceive me or trick me and call me not to do
right
what you had told me to do. Because if Yahweh tell you to do it, no matter, you know Satan don't want you to do it.
No, he doesn't.
Right.
So if Yahweh told you to do it and you started doing it, what his job is? Keep you from doing it, make you think you're not able to do it.
That's right? It. Right. Teach it.
Right. Yahweh tell you to do it, then you're able to do
that's
it.
That's right. He equipped it us. Yes.
You better equip. He ain't going to send you out there unequipped, right?
No, he's not.
So don't let nobody tell you unequipped.
That's right.
Because that, they doing what? The devil's work.
Yes, they are. Teach and tell it like it is. So hands can know.
So let's look at Daniel chapter 3. So these three are four Hebrew brothers.
Okay.
And Mishael and Azariah and Daniel, better known as Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, and Belshazzar. That didn't stick too well, but no. The three Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego stuck.
Yeah.
They got billions of sermons, if I'm not exaggerating too much, billions of sermons preached on Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
Yeah.
But that's not their name.
No, it's not.
All right, chapter 3 and verse 16 of Daniel. And it reads,
Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego answered in the mind to the high medical, O Nebuchadnezzar, we are not careful to answer thee in this matter.
So they wasn't careful to answer. Why they wasn't careful?
Right.
They wasn't fearful.
That's right. They had no fear, no doubt.
Afraid.
No doubt.
Why? Because they were strong in the word of Yahweh.
In the bars of Yahweh.
To be strong in the word of Yahweh did not have to have fear under the circumstances that they was facing.
Yes.
Right? You know the circumstances that they was facing?
Huh.
Didn't faith throw it in the fiery furnace.
That's right. Death.
But they're saying, hey, we are not careful to answer you. On this matter, read on.
If it be so, I am him who we have it, is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace. And Yahweh will deliver us out of thy hand, O Malach.
So he will deliver. So he said, we're not careful to answer. We're not fearful of the fiery furnace.
No doubt.
We're not fearful, though. That's what Yahweh tells us. Fear not.
That's right.
I'm with you.
Yes.
Fear not.
That's
I'm with you.
That's right.
Fear
praise
not.
On. Fear
I'm
not.
I'm with you.
And no doubt.
Because I'm the one I'm fighting about, but I'm with you. You don't see me, but I'm with you.
Yes, right? Yes, yes.
So that's what you have to know. So we're not careful to answer this. Okay. But the burning fiery furnace. And he will deliver.
Yes, yes.
Out of thy hand.
Yes, he will.
But if not,
be it known
unto thee, O king,
that
we will not serve thy help, thy worship, thy golden image, which thou hast set up.
Yes.
So that's courageous. You that's courageous.
Yes. Right.
Very courageous.
Yes, very.
Being very strong in the face of
really
adversity,
correct.
Right?
Yes.
Don't be very strong when there ain't no adversity, right?
Right,
there ain't
right.
Ain't nothing to deter you, nothing that you have to be thinking about that your fleshly mind would cause you to fear.
Huh.
Okay? But this is something your fleshly mind is going to, hey, take your eyes off of Yahweh. See, just like Kefa or Peter did.
Uh-huh.
Took his eyes off of Yahweh, and he feared what he seen.
Right.
Right. Rather than keeping his eyes on Yahweh,
that's
on Yeshua, he feared the waves.
Right? Uh-huh.
He feared the wind. But hey, who had control over the wind and over the wind?
Yahweh.
Well, Yeshua was still walking on the waves.
Yeshua,
And the wind was still blowing.
Yeah.
Why you take your eyes off?
Right.
Why you lose faith?
Right.
Because you was. He was catering to his flesh.
That's it. Teach it tell like it is.
Okay.
That's right.
These brothers wasn't. Right?
No, they wasn't.
He did not cater to their fleshly mind.
Right.
Therefore, they stood up and told him, hey, we are not worshiping no image, golden image that thou hast set up. Therefore, we have to do the same thing.
Yes. We must stand for thus says Yahweh.
This is what. This is what this is all about.
Yes, God, it is.
It's written here for
it's
us,
for
to,
us to get it and do it.
Like I said in verse 14, when we were writing out there because they got this tape, this name Nebuchadnezzar or Nebuchadrezzar, they announced it two or three different ways.
Right.
Spake and said unto them, it is true, O Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, do not ye serve my God. Amaya, nor Shaka, the golden image which I have set up. No, we don't.
Yeah.
We serve Yahweh.
Yeah, that's true. That's right.
When we were ignorant and stuff, we did.
That's
it.
Right. That's right.
But now we're out of ignorance. We're not
right.
going back into
no,
ignorance.
We're not
going to be deterred going back
no
into what we came
no,
out.
We're not
going back. So if we are serving JESUS, then we are serving this golden image.
Yes, we are.
That's the only thing I can say. Okay.
Yes, it is.
Because there's nothing that you can't be. JESUS. It can't be Jehovah.
Huh.
It can't be Yahweh. All is the same.
Is no, it's
be
not.
The same thing. Okay.
Right.
Said, saw, and see ain't the same, right?
No.
Even though they start with the same blood, but they ain't the same. So that, in this case, what Jehovah and JESUS and Yeshua don't start with the same blood.
That's right.
JESUS and Jehovah start with but not Yahweh. So you can't put that in there. So. We are not fearing and we're not going back.
No, we're not.
Yeah.
Is this what our captors have had us to do?
That's right.
So we are delivered from
that's
it.
Right. We were called out.
Hallelujah.
We were called out of darkness.
Right.
Yes.
All right, look at Daniel chapter 6. There is another thing where man, you have to stand up, you have to be courageous.
Yes, you do.
Have to be courage.
Yes.
And the only way we get our courage is from the word of Yahweh.
Praise the bars of Yahweh. God.
They don't just come overnight.
No, they do not.
We continue to
practice
the Yahweh word, doing what Yahweh says, then our courage grows.
That's right. Put it to practice.
It's growth.
Yes, it will.
It's growth. So their courage didn't just start when
they
were in the front of
it.
Because they had been seeing and been growing in courage.
Right.
Okay, so it wasn't just that, okay, devil, that more, okay, we got that.
They
were growing in it.
Right.
Oh, they were brought up
yes.
believing in Yahweh, and they had
that's
seen
it.
The results that Yahweh had done.
Yes.
Therefore, they had courage.
Yes, praise
when
him.
We have seen
that's right, praise
what Yahweh
him.
Had done for
oh,
us.
Oh, yes.
That encouraged
yes,
us.
It did. Yes, it does.
Greatly encouraged
yes, us. Yes, it does. Hear me now to hear me now.
That's true.
All right, chapter 6. Let's look at verse 10. And it reads,
now when Daniel knew Amar that the writing was signed, he went into his bath and his windows being open in his chamber toward Jerusalem, he kneeled upon his knee 3 times a yom and palad and gave todah before his Elohim as he did aforetime.
So he didn't change his
no,
routine.
No, he did.
Okay.
No fear.
Right.
We don't change our routine.
No.
Because some paper had been signed.
That's right.
This paper had been signed by Yahweh. Okay?
Yes.
Amen.
This is the word of Yahweh. It's been signed, sealed, and delivered.
Yes, it has.
The Alpha and the Tau. Put his approval on it. So therefore, you don't change.
Cannot.
Routine. Because they signed the paper and said, okay, now you can't worship Yahweh no more. You got to worship what I made.
Right, right.
So then you knew it. He didn't change his routine.
Right.
Stop serving.
Right. Praise
that.
Praise
Yahweh.
That's right. Praise him.
Yahweh offered up his prayer to Yahweh, not to no image. Okay?
That's right. Teach it to like it is.
All right. Read.
Then these are done assembled and found Daniel Palan and making supplication before his Elohim.
So they found it. They were looking for it. This was the whole thing. This was the whole scheme behind it.
Yeah.
To do this, to make him break the law that the king set up so they could get rid of him because he was over them.
Yeah.
Okay. Which really had saved their lives.
Yeah.
Of the king was going to kill him because they couldn't tell that dream. So, but Daniel, serving the true and true Elohim,
yes, the true,
inquired of him, and he and the secret was revealed.
Yes,
and he told it to the king. So therefore, the king spared him and all these other princes that he had set up. Okay, but they was not satisfied.
No,
they
wasn't
to get rid of him.
So you can never satisfy Adon.
Right. Verse 12 says,
then they came near and Amar before the high matter concerning the high matter decree. Hast thou not signed a decree that every Adam that shall ask a petition of any Elohim or Adam within 30 yom, save of thee, O Malak, shall he be cast into the den of lions? Then Malak answered and Amar, the thing is imminent, according to the high tower of the Medes and Persians, which authorized not.
So now the Medes and Persian law was unbreakable.
Right.
But people break Yahweh's
law. Yeah, right, right.
Right.
And who above the Medes and the Persians?
Yahweh.
His law stands above all laws.
All laws forever.
They have laws based upon his laws, but his laws
right, are right.
laws of law.
That's it.
We should always obey his law.
Always. Amen. His and his only. Amen.
With his law, when the man's law conflict with Yahweh's huh. law, what they say, who you gonna call?
Huh.
Yahweh.
Yahweh. Call on
who
Yahweh.
Who you gonna obey?
Yahweh. Call upon his yes. great champ.
Yes.
So he's saying, but the Medes, the laws of the Medes and the Persians, which ought to not mean huh. they don't change.
They don't change. It
they
is
don't
law.
Change. Whatever been written, that's going to happen.
That's what's got to be carried out.
You're not like the law we have over here that, okay, they get so many retrials, how many stays right. of execution,
right.
so many more trials. Hey, if it says you die,
that's it.
Die.
That's it.
No lawyers, no nothing. That's it.
Uh-huh.
Been written, so let it be done.
That's it.
Said.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Verse 13 said,
and then at Amar day and Amar before the high man, that Daniel which is up the top band of the captive of Yehuda, regardeth not thee, O Malak, nor the decree that thou hast signed, but make his petition three times a yom.
He's making his petition three times a day.
Yeah.
To the true and living.
Yes, yes, praise God.
Something that somebody made.
Right.
That what they were worshiping was something that they made,
amen.
But Yahweh made the material that they used to make the
thing. That's right.
Amen.
And they worshiping it. And it can't do anything.
Nothing.
Because it can't move.
No, it cannot.
It can't speak.
Uh-huh.
It can't talk.
Right.
It can't hit you. It can't kill you.
They do not.
Let somebody pick it up and drop it on you.
Right.
You
know, amen.
And yeah, it would probably kill you, crush you to death. But other than that, or it falls on you.
Yeah.
Killed. But other than that, it can't do nothing to you.
Nothing.
It can't even frown at you.
Uh-uh.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Where we at?
Israel
13. Alright, 14.
Then the high Malak, when he shamar thee the bar, was sore displeased with himself, and set his leg peg on Daniel to deliver him, and he labored till the going down of the sun to deliver him.
So he labored, he's waiting. He's he wanted, but he didn't want to do it, but hey, he was bound by his law.
Right, right.
Rather than by the law of Yahweh.
Uh-huh.
So people are bound by the law that they hear people present to
it. Yeah, that's it. Teacher tell like
it's not necessary the law of Yahweh.
No, it's not.
You're bound by the law of observing tomorrow.
Uh-huh.
You know it's not sanctioned by Yahweh.
No, it's not. Teach it, tell it like it is, so the animals can know.
But because somebody standing behind the pulpit like I'm standing,
uh-huh.
or altar like I'm standing, so therefore they believe that that person is representing Yahweh.
Of Yahweh, right. True representative.
He's not.
He's not. Teach it, tell it like it is.
Because they can't, no way they can justify it or prove it any way,
nowhere.
Shape, or form.
Uh-uh.
Every time we see something about the first day of the week, it followed after the 7 days.
That's right. Teach it.
Amen.
So, look on your calendar.
Right? Right, it says.
Yeah.
After the 7 day follows what?
The first day of the Yom.
Not Monday. The one that they call Sunday.
Right.
It's the first day of the
Yom. Yes, it is. Right.
So, if some of you was confused about it, okay? Okay, verse 15.
Then these are the armor similar unto the high Malak and Amar to the high Malak. Amar, O Malak, that the high Torah, the Medes and Persians, is that no decree nor statute which the high Malak itself may be changed.
These men are similar unto the Malik, unto the king.
Right.
And Amar unto the king, know, O king, that the law of the Medes and Persians is that no decree nor statute which the king have established may be changed.
Huh.
they got this down to a pat, but now somehow people think that Yahweh's laws can be changed.
Yeah, teachers tell like that's right. They say it's done away with.
It's a mere man.
Uh-huh.
And they said that they creed can't be changed.
Right.
But Yahweh said, he changed not.
That's right. Same yesterday.
So whatever he spoke cannot be changed.
No, it cannot. Yeah. Teach it. Tell it like it is. Praise the mighty Yah. Yes.
Right. But yet people come up with all kind of ways to change.
Yeah.
Sure.
Try to change.
That's
they
it.
They do.
Well, they do change it, but they change it bogus because they don't have the power.
That's right. That's right.
They saying that Yahweh gave them the power to change it, but no, he didn't give them the power.
No, he did not.
They're lying.
That's it, right. Teacher. That's all it is.
So when you're faced with this kind of thing, then you have to be courageous.
Yes,
right?
It's a must.
You have to be huzzah.
Hallelujah.
Right.
Yes.
So read.
Then I met Shabbat, and they brought Daniel and cast him into the den of lions.
Mm-hmm.
Now the high medic Amar and Amar unto Daniel. Dial him who dies ever is continue, he will deliver thee.
So even though he did it, now he said, hey, he will deliver thee.
Yeah.
But he's not going to break his law.
Uh-huh.
He's not going to break the laws of they have established.
Right, right.
But now he's saying, in Yemenah, Yoel will deliver you.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
So he had some, but he still like catered to his own. So we can probably, and then we can cater to our own
right.
Belief, right?
Yeah, yeah.
But we don't want to do that.
Uh-uh.
That's dangerous.
Only yours.
That's dangerous, okay?
Yes, it is.
It is. Right.
Okay, verse 17 says,
and a stone was brought and laid upon the mouth of the den, and the Hamelech sealed it with his own signet, and the signet of his not be, and the and that they purpose might not be changed concerning Daniel.
So they was destined to do what they wanted to do, right?
Yeah.
Right. Put the stones over, make sure he don't get out, right?
Right. Yeah.
Right.
That the purpose might not be changed concerning Daniel.
Yeah.
Right? They wanted to destroy. They wanted to kill.
Yeah.
Him, okay?
Yeah.
Because he was serving Yah.
That's it.
They wanted him to change. Now, if he changed from serving Yahweh to serving what they wanted him to serve, now he's going to do what? Lose his life.
That's right.
His physical life, his spiritual life.
Yes, sir. Teach
so he's going to be lost eternally. He's going to be separated from Yahweh. What? Eternally.
Because
you turn your back from the true to a lie.
To the true living
Elohim.
You
turn your back from the one that created everything.
That's right.
To something that didn't create nothing.
Right.
Right.
So. Let's get down to verse 19 and read.
Then Ahimelech arose very early in the morning, went in haste and to the den of lions.
Mm-hmm.
And when he came to the den, he cried a lamentable voice unto Daniel. And Ahimelech Amar and Amar to Daniel, O Daniel, Abbot of the High Kaya Elohim, is thy Elohim who thou everest continue able to deliver thee from the lions?
Yeah, read.
Then upon Daniel unto the Hamelech, O Malik, Kaya forever.
So now Daniel reads out to him out loud then.
Right, right.
It's
so,
a yes.
It's a yes, he is.
Praise praise the mighty Yah. Hallelujah. Praise him.
In other words, there's nothing too hard
for him.
Nothing too hard for him, okay?
Nothing.
So therefore, when this is synced in your spirit or in your mind,
right.
Then you don't have no fear.
That's right.
Because there you know he can, whether he do it or not, you know he can.
That's right.
Whether
that's
he do it or not, you know he
that's
can.
That's right.
And if he don't do it, you know what? I'm going to be with him.
That's right.
Okay.
That's it.
So my purpose, my time is up for, you know, he's let my time
right.
Serve my time.
Right.
I'm time for me to go and be at rest.
That's right? It. Teacher tell it like it is.
until the resurrection, right?
Yeah.
So I know if I die doing what he says, then I'm gonna be on him when I wake up. I'm gonna be in his presence.
Yes, we're gonna be in his kavod.
Not in the lake of fire, right?
Well, that's it. Teach it till like it is.
Then said Dion to the king, O king, Kai forever. My Elim has sent his
Malak,
or his angel,
and
have shut the lion's mouth, that they had no
heard. That's right.
For me. For as much as before him in innocent was found in
me. Yes.
Found in me, eh?
Yeah.
He knew Anderson was found. He
King right.
Knew
Anderson. He knew it. He knew it.
And also before thee, O King,
that's right.
No hurt.
That's right.
So
that's right.
By the power of Yahweh that you got, or the Koach of Yahweh that you have in you, will cause you to do these exploits. Will cause you to stand
up. Yes, they will. Yes, they have.
You won't sit down. You won't back up.
Not for what's right.
For what's right. Right.
Right.
So we don't want to back up. Or we back up and turn our back on what is righteous. Then we turn our back on Yahweh. Then we
turn our
back into what? The lake of fire.
That's it. That's what you're running back
to. All right, let's look at Yakadon of John chapter 19. And these are examples. So
he's
talking about Yeshua.
And for us,
he was strong. He had no fear.
No fear, no doubt.
So that means you and I should know that.
That's it. He's our example.
Oh, the greater one is in us than is in
us. Yes, it is. Praise the mighty Yah.
Right.
So, sooner we realize that, the more empowered we're going to be.
Yes, we will. Yes, we have.
19:10 says,
Then Amar Pilate unto him, Amarest thou not unto me? Amarest thou not that I have popped my shell to crucify thee and have my shell to release thee?
Well, then this is what, so he thinks he got power. He said, Then said Pilate unto him, Speak thou not unto me, knowest thou not that I have my shell to crucify thee and have my shell to release thee?
Uh-huh.
But you don't have nothing but what my father gave
you. That's right. What he allowed.
And Yeshua answered,
Thou couldst have no Michelle at all against me, except it were given thee from above. Therefore, he that delivered me unto thee have the greater Hatah.
When they delivered to you, have the greater Hatah. He's talking about Yehuda Harris right now. So he delivered you to it, but you don't have no power. That's my father had.
Right. That's right.
You don't have that power.
You don't. So
the power we have comes from who?
Yahweh.
You know where the power we have comes from? Yahweh.
Yes, it does.
When we get weakness, you know that where that comes from. Come from fear, right?
That's it.
Weakness comes from fear, stand from fear.
Yes, it does. Teach it to us like it is.
Power stands from Yahweh.
Yes, it does.
Praise Abba Yahweh.
Praise
Yahweh.
Let's look at Acts chapter 7, verse 51. This is, man, the same thing. They're just showing you people that have this courage.
Yes, yes.
In the face of adversity.
That's right. He wants us to get it.
And showing you that they believe the word of Yahweh.
Uh-huh.
They were willing to die for
that's
the word
right.
of Yahweh, no matter what.
No matter what.
So you got to come. Though you're not always going to be delivered out of the thing before it happens.
That's right.
With the Hebrew brothers, they didn't get delivered before they got thrown
that's
into the furnace.
Right.
Daniel didn't get delivered before he got thrown into the lion's den, but he got delivered.
Yes.
So just because you don't get you have to go through
it. Go through it, that's right. That's right. You just sung
you don't go through it, then you don't know Yahweh.
You don't know.
You see Yahweh demonstrate his power, right?
That's right. You say prove
Yahweh demonstrated his power not just for them,
uh-huh.
but he demonstrated his power to the people that were doing these things to them.
Yes.
So you have to see it.
Yes.
Before these things happen, so his power could be demonstrated to the people that were persecuting them.
Uh-huh. Right? And it will.
So, Acts 7 and 51. And it reads,
You stiff-necked and uncircumcised in pay, and as ye do always resist the high Kadesh Ruach as your fathers did, so do ye.
So they were getting ready to kill him. He tell them they want to kill him, but now he telling them this is why they want to kill him. Because he's telling them what they done.
Yeah.
And when you're telling people what they have done, Yahweh having to tell
the
people
truth.
What they done.
They don't want to hear it.
That's right.
They rejected him, even though you telling them, they rejected him still, but
that's
they
right.
think they rejecting you.
That's right.
But they really rejected
that's
him, right?
Yes, they are.
They you stiff-necked and uncircumcised in mind and ear.
Uh-huh.
You all do always resist the Kadosh Ruach or the Holy Ghost that they got in your Bible.
Uh-huh.
As your abbas did or your father did, so do ye.
Yep.
Which of these prophets have not your fathers persecuted?
Huh.
Why were they persecuting the prophets?
For the
because
truth.
Telling the truth,
for
right?
The truth.
Which they didn't want. Even though they claimed to believe in
uh-huh.
Yahweh, they didn't want the truth of Yahweh.
That's it.
They didn't want the truth of Yahweh the way that he was presented, okay? Where did I stop? Persecuted.
52, yeah.
Yeah. Which of the prophets have not your abbas persecuted,
huh.
And they have slain them, which showed before the coming.
That's right.
Of the
just one. Yahshua.
Just one. They were telling them about the just one, which is Yeshua.
Yes, the Lamb.
And they didn't want to hear
it. They did not. Still today.
Of whom you have been now a betrayer.
Uh-huh.
And murder,
uh-huh.
right?
Uh-huh.
Who have received the law by dispensation of angels and have not kept it.
Have not, nope, and not kept it. That's it.
So we're not, see, we can, coming down, and it's like angels giving it to us now because it's been here written.
That's right.
He's been here preserved for us to let us
yes,
know.
Yes.
That he want us to have it.
Uh-huh.
Want us to flourish in it.
Yes.
Want us to know about it.
Yes, he does.
Well, if we know about it, then we can do it. So
that's
this
right, we can act on
and
it.
And guess what? This guy, Stephen or Stephen, they stoned him to death for telling the truth.
Huh,
so,
right.
So no matter what people say, truth is not readily accepted.
No, it's not. No, it's not.
Yeah.
They say they love the truth.
Huh.
Up to a point.
Right.
There's some part of the truth they don't want because it's going to take them beyond. They are flesh.
That's it. Teach and tell like it is. That's it.
Or he's going to restrain.
That's right. They got to give up some things.
Flesh want to do. Okay.
Right.
I love the truth, but I love my own child. Okay?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, the truth of Yahweh have to be on set on the back burner because I want my folks. Or I want my children.
Yeah. Teach and tell like it is.
Or he said, don't eat them, but.
Right.
That truth I don't want to hear.
Yeah.
It tastes too good to not to be
true.
True. One preacher say, hey, bacon is Yahweh's command for you.
Oh, no, he didn't.
Yeah, he did. Trying to be facetious, but hey,
yeah.
You got to give an account of that, brother.
Oh, that's right. For every vein the bar you spoke.
Give an account of that, brother.
Yeah.
Okay, Hebrews chapter 11. Commands you to eat. I think I'm quoting him just about how he said it. Anyway, it was similar to that.
That's right.
Hebrews 11:23 says,
by every now, Moshe, when he was born, was hid 3 months of his parents. Because they saw he was a proper Zakar, and they were not afraid of the high Malik's Mizpah.
So they weren't afraid of the king of Egypt, Mizpah, his command. They weren't
nope,
afraid.
Nope.
Right.
Okay. So, again, that's what Yahweh wants us to do. He is admonishing us not to be afraid, not to be fear.
Not of
you know,
nothing.
A lot of people usually we hear the preacher. Fear Yahweh, when Yahweh say, fear not.
That's right.
Fear me not. Don't fear me.
That's right.
Reverence
them,
me,
it.
But don't
respect
fear
respect them.
But I don't know if they're doing that to get a point across, but that's not the point that Yahweh wants
no,
to
he does. Not that way.
He wants you to respect me.
That's
reverence
it.
Me. Don't fear me.
Uh-huh.
I mean, if you fear me, you're not doing
it. You're not going to come to him.
You're not doing it voluntarily. You're not doing it willingly.
Right.
You're doing it because you fear
uh-huh.
what's going to happen to you.
Right, right.
He don't want that. If he did, he just made us all do right.
That's right, some zombies, yeah.
When they give us free moral agents, right?
Right,
we're
gonna
be free to do what we want. But he been giving us freedom to do
yes,
what we
has.
Want, okay?
Yes, he has.
All right, look at Psalm chapter 3. Where he's telling us to be fearless.
Yes.
Or you think he's telling us to be fearless for? Don't want us to fear.
That's right.
Fearless.
Uh-huh.
Be fearless.
That's it.
Psalm chapter 3 and verse 6 says,
I would not be afraid of 10,000 of them that have set themselves against me round about. Praise the mighty Yah.
This is the psalmist saying, I don't care how many
that's
around
right.
me, I won't be afraid.
That's right.
I won't fear.
Because Yah was with me.
You know who's with you?
Yeah.
You can make this same statement.
That bold
but if
statement.
You don't know it and don't have him in the word of Yahweh, then you can't.
That's right.
This is just something that sounds foolishness to you.
Uh-huh.
Right?
That's hey, it.
Why wouldn't I be afraid of all these people around me? Because Yahweh said nothing.
That's right. Thus right? says Yahweh.
He said, I will not be afraid
uh-huh.
of 10,000 of people that I am
uh-huh.
that have set themselves against me around about me. I'm not going to be saved.
That's right.
Say, arise, O Yahweh,
yeah.
save me, O
yes.
my Elohim.
Yes.
For thou hast smitten all of my
enemies
upon the cheekbone. Thou hast broken the teeth of the un-Elohim.
Right. Praise the mighty Yahweh. Praise him.
Yahweh.
Yes.
Yahel.
That's right.
Okay?
Yes.
So, in other words, this is what you got to know. Going in.
Yes, going in.
You have to be in you going in so you can resist
yes.
what Satan is doing.
Must be rooted in you.
Okay?
Yeah.
Look at chapter 27 of Psalm. So these people are not saying it's just to be saying
no, they're not.
And Yahweh did not let them say that just to be saying
no,
it.
No, he's not.
He's saying it to us so we can be what?
Encouraged. That's it.
He calls us to be fearless.
Yep.
He calls us to not have no fear.
No doubt.
We know who's with us.
Yes,
right?
Yes, yes.
27 and 3. And it reads,
though in Sabaoth should encamp against me, my pace and not fear. Though war should arise against me, in this will I be confident.
So we have to be confident in the word of Yahweh.
That's it. That's the only way.
That's how he's confident, you see.
Yep.
Because he said, though a host encamp against me, my heart, in the English they put in there, but it's your mind.
It's your mind.
Shall not fear, or my spirit won't fear, okay?
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
The war should arise against me, in this will I be confident.
Yes.
One thing have I desired of Yahweh.
Yeah.
That will I seek after.
Yeah.
That I may dwell in the abides of Yahweh.
Yahweh, praise the mighty
Yah. All the yams of my kind.
Yes.
Right.
And to behold the beauty of Yahweh.
Beautiful.
And to inquire
in his temple. Yes, we are. Praise the mighty Yah.
Praise the
mighty
temple.
Yes.
Then don't be afraid.
That's it.
Because he's telling us, don't do it. He having the summons to tell
us. Uh-huh.
So it's like him telling us.
Yes, it is.
Look at 46 and 2. This should be enough to encourage
yes.
you.
Yes.
46 yeah. and 2 and it reads.
Therefore we would not fear, though the high earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea.
So we ain't gonna be afraid. Whatever
no
happens.
No matter what's going
afraid.
On.
Right.
Our first one is saying, Yahweh is our refuge.
Yes, he is.
So you know that Yahweh is your refuge.
Yes.
Your strength.
Uh-huh.
And very present,
help.
Help in the time of trouble.
Right
in your
now.
Time of trouble.
Right
you
now,
know that he's your present help.
He's right
him.
Now,
praise Yahweh. He's present.
Yes,
present help in the time of
yes,
trouble.
Yes, he is.
In the time of trouble, when you're on his side.
Uh huh. That's it, teacher. That's the key word. When you're walking with Yahweh.
Yahweh is our refuge. That meaning you're doing what he said.
That's it.
He's your refuge.
That's the only way.
You're crying out to him, you're serving
yes.
him,
uh-huh.
magnifying him, he said.
Yes.
Though the waters thereof
uh-huh.
rose and troubled, though the mountains shake with swelling thereof sealed.
See,
I'm not be afraid. I'm still,
nothing.
I'm still standing firm.
We're unmovable.
I'm movable, unshakable.
Yeah.
Always abiding.
That's
in
right.
So these are. Scripture let us know we are not supposed to fear.
We do not.
what surrounds us, right?
Uh-huh.
Because Yahweh is our help in our present time, right? In the present time of trouble, Yahweh, we know
He's our help. Praise the mighty God. Praise Him.
Psalm 91 and 5.
Praise Him.
When trouble comes, people want to hide from Yahweh.
That's right. Call upon Yahweh. They want to
forget Yahweh. Hey, they're looking for the government. They're looking for the army. Okay, hey.
Call upon Yah.
That's not your present help in a time of trouble. Your present help in a time of trouble
is always Yahweh.
And you have to know that He's always with you. So you won't be afraid.
Right.
Amen.
All right, 90 of what?
91 and 5.
91? And what did I say?
5.
Okay, let's read it then. Praise God, Yahweh.
Praise Him.
Read.
Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by Liar, nor by the arrow that flies by Yon.
So Yahweh, stood out.
Neither one.
Just keep on telling us, don't be afraid. Yeah. Don't fear. Don't
day
be
or
afraid.
Night.
Be fearless. Okay, that's some people going out there. Well, see, the night you ain't supposed to do and stay in the house, folks. Everything is bad out there. So sadly, you're not going out at night. It's like you're afraid to go out at night.
That's fear?
So that's fear, but that didn't come from Yahweh.
No, it didn't.
Why you can't walk at night?
Right. Yah be with us.
Why you can't go out at night? You don't see that in Scripture nowhere about the night is bad and you can't go out.
Right,
I mean,
right.
Some things happening tonight.
Right.
Because people call themselves hiding.
Yeah, they think so.
Okay, trying to get away in the night, but that don't mean that Yahweh don't want you to go out at night.
Right.
But this is a theory that people have. Most of the theory is because they don't want to shock all Yahweh and lie up.
Okay. Teach you tell it like it is.
They don't want the day to have no night.
Impossible.
But they start with the night.
That's right. Teach you tell it like it is.
And it ends when the sun goes down again.
That's right.
When the 12 hours.
Right.